The AirPods, the new third gen AirPods, those interest me. I'm really curious about these because I've been impressed with my AirPods Pro once I especially got the right tips for them. But I don't like using them for phone calls nearly as much as I like using my OG AirPods. And the reason is that the AirPods Pro seal in my ear. I don't like using anything that seals in my ear for phone calls because I'm used to hearing my voice out loud. And yes, if I turn on transparency mode with the AirPods Pro, I get some amount of my voice sort of, you know, pumped back in, kind of like what we do with the podcast when we record here. So it's okay. But I, you know, when I'm talking on the phone, I'm used to hearing my voice. And the OG AirPods sit in my ear nicely. They work really well. They're the ones that I leave at my desk. But the batteries on those are, you know, dying quite a bit. So I was curious to see these third gen AirPods, and I did order a set of them. I like, so they don't, we have a, there's a chart that Apple has that I want to pull up to make sure I'm doing all this right. But the third gen AirPods add spatial audio, which I think is great. They do not have noise cancellation or transparency mode, nor could they, because they don't seal in your ear. So it would be super difficult to, you know, try and mitigate for external sounds when you're not sealing them out with hardware, mm-hmm. essentially. Right. So bear that in mind. That's, I would think that's probably the biggest difference for most people between AirPods third gen and AirPods Pro is that, you know, you don't get noise cancellation because they don't seal it out. You do get, that, but the battery life on them, they say, is, you know, 6 hours. We'll see where that goes and all of that over, you know, over
the
course.
Is this new? Force sensor control.
It is new. Yeah.
Okay. So it's like a touch sensor, I guess. Okay.
Yeah. I mean, they've had a touch sensor on the AirPods in the past. This one, I think you're right. Yeah. There's something new about the way that it works.
Well, the older ones, wasn't it more or less a button? Whereas this is like a pressure sensor, I guess
there is no button on the OG AirPods. You just tap it. Right. But yeah, this is the same one that's in the AirPods Pro is now in. So essentially they took the AirPods Pro and made a non seal in your ear version of it. And that's what these third gen AirPods are, which is cool. You know, it's fine. Yeah, if you look on Apple's AirPods comparison screen, they've got the force sensor allows you to, you know, press and hold to do things with mm-hmm. Siri, and it's a little more, it can sense more granularly, so you can do more things with it, just like you can with the AirPods Pro. So I think that's a, like, I'm glad that they're doing that, because I know a lot of people did not like the AirPods Pro for exactly the reason that the AirPods Pro can be the AirPods Pro, because they seal in your ear and all that good stuff. So, yeah. Okay. Yeah, I know. It's interesting. So hopefully that we actually had that question in the chat room as we were setting up the show from Barry. So hopefully that answers your question, Barry.